Hi guys. So I've put together some dictionary paper packs and map paper packs for my Etsy shop, and I'll show you those in a minute. But I just wanted to show you this gorgeous dictionary before I pull it apart because it's just so cool. Okay, look at this. It's just massive. This spine is absolutely huge. Okay, look how cool this is. You can see it's all falling apart. The cover is has come away from the main book. But look at this. I just had to show you this before I pulled it apart. Okay, how wide is it? It's a 12 centimeter spine. So 12 centimeters is, oh my gosh, I should work this out before I even start the camera. 12 centimeters is what, 4.5, 5 inches, I think, roughly. But it's just so cool. I love it. I've had this for ages. I found it in an op shop, a charity op shop, years ago, and it's been on my bookshelf for so long. It takes up so much room, it weighs a ton, and I've always meant to pull it apart for paper packs, but I just didn't. I just love it too much, but it's time. Anyway, so yeah, it's off the spine. It wasn't when I got it. When I first picked it up, it just came away from the spine because the glue isn't that strong anymore after all these years. But look how it's bound. It's actually got screws. It's got a screw there, screw there. This is the same material that's on the cover. It's like kind of a fabric covered card. Two big screws there. Screws in the back. Kind of like a floating spine. And then they've just glued that to the spine of the, to the cover of the book. But how cool is it? And look at the end paper. Owls. I think that might be their logo. I've seen that on a few of their books. Oh yeah, here. But it's so cool. I couldn't see a year in this. What year it was printed. But I am blind. Oh, actually, I lie. There it is. It looks 60s or 70s to me from the pages. Oh gosh, I can't see it. I think it says 68. Yeah, the pages look 68, but it's one of those dictionaries with the color pictures. How cool. I just love it. It's such a cool dictionary. Oh, look at these. The old cars. Aren't they gorgeous? They'd make great little journaling cards. Maybe in steampunk journals or something, but butterfly. Anyway, it's so cool. I just absolutely love it. And I wanted to show you that before I pull out the electric screwdriver to pull that apart. Isn't it cool? Okay, so some pages from this dictionary will go into my vintage dictionary paper packs. Oh my gosh, there's no room on my desk to even put this. Okay, so I've started pulling apart dictionaries, so if you've followed my channel for a while, you know that I have so many dictionaries and map books, atlases, street directories, things like that. And they're taking up room on my bookshelf, so I need to get rid of some. So I've decided to just make dictionary paper packs where it's all dictionary pages, and then map paper packs where it's all different maps, so atlases, street directories, things like that. Now, I've started pulling them apart. But this is not all of them because I've pulled apart 10 dictionaries so far. But yeah, I've got plenty more. So you will receive some of these pages in your pack if you were to get one. And also some other dictionary pages. But they're all vintage dictionaries. The oldest one is... I was writing them down as I went. The oldest is 1957. And the most recent is 1980. So... dictionaries between 1957 and 1980. Okay, so this, I love this dictionary. This one's one of the older ones. This was, I think, 1958. It's small, it's cute. I was going to put all the dictionaries aside and show you them first, which is usually what I do with my paper packs. But there's just too many, and I just love showing the whole, you know, book where it comes from. But yeah, there's just too many, and there was too many atlases, so I've gone ahead and pulled them apart. But yeah, really cute. So there's some little pages from there. So you'll just get a combination of all of these pages and some others that I'm pulling apart. But these are the smallest. I won't be putting any more small ones in. The rest are larger pages. So this is the smallest one. Okay, maybe I should start from... I'm going to start from the bottom because it's just easier to stack them. Oh no, that's okay. I'm so unprepared. So you get some of those. I haven't decided how many pages I'll put in packs yet, but because I just need to finish pulling them apart and weigh them. So I want them to fit into large letter envelopes so that the postage isn't too much. This is from a shorthand book, shorthand dictionary. So I've tried to give a big range of sizes, the color, the tones of the pages. See, this one's a lot whiter than this. And different types, so shorthand, French. I've got a Chinese one somewhere. I need to find it. Yeah, so I'll give you a mix of different dictionary pages. Just because they're so interesting. Like, look at the color of these pages. This is the French dictionary. Now, where I can, I've left the pages double like this because I think it gives you more options if you want to put a whole thing in your journal. I'd imagine a lot of you would be ripping them up, but where I can, I'll leave them double pages, but some of them like this, you know, the pages are glued in, so they'll be single pages. But you'll get multiples of them. So that's the French. This is probably going to be so boring showing you dictionary pages. I'm not sure if it's this one. Okay, it is. Okay, this is an Aussie Fair Dinkum dictionary. So, you know, Aussie dictionaries, it's full of slang, and a lot of the slang is a bit cheeky or tongue-in-cheek. So, yeah, don't be offended because it's just our Aussie sense of humor. And some of the words you may not know, like, you know, crack. If you're an Aussie, you know what crack is, and I don't mean a drug. Okay, so there's... that. Those. I can't remember which each dictionary was from. I wrote them down, but they're all different. This one has little pictures. And I'll make sure each pack gets pages with little pictures as well. But some will be blank just because. Actually, no. I think I picked out all. I won't say. I'll try and put ones with little pictures in each pack. But of course, some pages are just text with no little pictures. I love these ones. So these are single pages as well. That one might have been a thesaurus. These ones also have the little pictures. Oh, look, I just love them. They're so cute. These caterpillars. Actually, that dictionary is really cute. So they're double pages. What else? Think that was one. So these ones also have the little pictures on them. This one, the binding. Oh, these ones are terrible to pull apart. A lot of the old encyclopedias are like this. They've actually just got holes and then a thick string, like a cotton string like this. Whoops. I don't want to lose my needle. Yeah, a cotton string threaded through and tied off on the top and bottom. And then they're glued down the spine. They're so hard to pull apart, these. They put these strings so tight. And you can't see the string from the spine. They're just, up and down. Those. And these. This one's beautiful. Look at the color of the pages. Now, I've got quite a few different dictionaries that are this size, this texture paper as well. It's thick and matte, and they're all different. So some have, where there's a little cut out. I probably should have brought that one. There's a little, yeah, I should have brought it to show you, but there's little thumb cutouts down the pages, so you kind of see them vertically down the spine of the book. Some are like that, some are like this, some have the gilded gold pages and stuff like that. But anyway, this is just a kind of sample of what I've started pulling apart, but there'll be different sizes, different types of dictionaries. Some are different languages, French, Chinese or Japanese, I'm not sure. Yeah, the Aussie Tinkham Dictionary, which is actually quite a fun read. There's a few thesauruses in there, I think one or two maybe. This will be the smallest one you get, but yeah, just to give you an indication. Okay, map packs. Oh my gosh. Okay. Maps are the same thing, just a variety of sizes, different types of street directories, atlases. There's some travel maps, the maps that open out really big. I don't have a lot of those, so I'll pop those in the first packs that are ordered. Yeah, anyway, so. Same thing. If I can, I've left the pages doubled. But some, of course, are single. Now, because some of these pages are quite big to post, I will fold them if I have to, because you can see something like this. This is huge. So this is a Britain road atlas, and the pages are huge. So I don't normally fully package up my stuff until I send the order out, because depending on the order is how I'll wrap it. So if you were to just order a paper pack, those won't fit in a large envelope because of the large sizes. I would have to fold the bigger pages in half. If you ordered this and other stuff, that it needs to go in a larger box. If it'll fit in the box without folding it, then I'll put it in there. So just depends what your order is as to how I package it. But where I can, I'll try not to fold pages. Okay, so some little ones. Oh, I love this one. This is actually out of a like a bushwalking trail for Australia. So Wollemi National Park. Look, I love these. These look so cool in collages, or you know, tags where you just have, you know, some book page or map page and something else with it. But I love these. I've had this book for ages. I've been using it in journals myself. Kind of don't want to let it go. So this one, some pages have a map on just one side. Some have double-sided. It'll just be random. Okay, what else? Street directories. You know, the funny thing is that we take these for granted now, but in years to come, they won't have these. They don't print street directories really much anymore, do they? Because we've all got mobile phones and apps. And so this is out of a street directory. So different sizes. I love this one. It's all browns mostly from memory. Yeah. Like, look how cool that is. So I've tried to pick out as big a mix of sizes and, you know, different variations. This one's narrow. I quite like the narrow ones. These are pretty, the pink ones. How nice is that? Like, just as a background page. That one, I just love that page. And these ones are really thick, double page as well. I love the thick pages. Look how cool that is. I actually had so many maps. I used to offer coffee dyed map pages in my Etsy shop, but I haven't had those in quite a while. And I punched out a whole bunch of scalloped map pages. I think I've got one or two packs left in my Etsy shop, just because I was trying to get rid of some. It's like a bad addiction. If I see an atlas at an op shop or a street directory, I must buy it. If it's an older one, not so much the new ones. I don't really care about those. They don't interest me. See, they're all, I mean, maps, but different. Those ones are cool. These are quite thick, like card. So, a lot you can do with all those. What else? I'm running out of room. So these are the bigger pages. I've left these all double paged as well. I mean, obviously you'll cut them down to size when you use them in your journals, depending what you use them for. These are the ones, a few of you may have received orders with map envelopes. So they're really big, thick pages. Sometimes I make my own envelopes just because they look so cool. So some are matte, some are semi-gloss. There's a few high gloss ones in there. Okay, this one I really love. Hold on. This one. I love this one. This Atlas, it's really thick. It was one of the, I think it was from the 60s, but really thick and really beautiful. Had a whole bunch of little animal, Australian native animals in the back of it with information about them, and you could cut them out. But just the color, I just love these ones. Okay, and this is the British Road Atlas. Look at that. How cool is that? I love that these ones are so colourful as well. That's a different one, I think. Anyway, so this isn't all of them. I've still got more to pull apart, but I just want to get these piles off my desk and get them onto my I've got a separate shelf where I put all my stuff for my Etsy stock, but I don't put anything there until I actually list it in my shop. So those are the maps, and those are the dictionary pages. And I'll still be pulling apart, adding different ones to those. But those will be available in my Etsy shop. And a few of you have asked for coffee dye papers. In fact, that's one of the things I've always been asked for. Coffee dyed papers. I may put some in my shop. I won't promise. The reason that I don't is, let me show you. Okay, you know I'm a recycler. I don't buy coffee photocopy paper or any new papers. The only new craft supplies I buy is glues, paints, inks, and things like that I can't make myself, book corners and eyelets. Everything else is recycled. So my photocopy paper that you see me use in my journals is usually from papers that have been printed on and I've come across somewhere. Now, these particular bundles look like my daughter's old university notes that she was going to throw away. But mostly they're from my husband's work. He has a photocopy room at work, and they have, you know, if you're in Australia, you know, there's usually a blue bin for non-security papers. And then a different bin for security papers, which is, you know, locked and goes for shredding. But the non-security bin, he usually just every now and then brings me a bundle of papers to use. And so I use papers out of that. So my blank pages, as you can imagine, if you get a pile of printed pages, if you find blank pages, they're kind of like gold. And usually I don't have that many. So I coffee dye those and use them in my own journal making because I don't really have enough to stock my shelf. But for some reason, my husband purchased a brand new ream of photocopy paper for me as part of my Mother's Day present. I know, it's weird. But so I may coffee dye those and put them in my Etsy shop. Yes, he was in big trouble for buying new paper because I just don't buy paper. There's so much paper out in the world already. I just don't think we need to keep producing so much more. But anyway, that's it. If I do put coffee dyed papers in my Etsy, I'll do a separate video anyway. I like to show what you're getting. Anyway, that's it. I'm rambling. And thank you everyone for your support. I know I've been MIA for a while. I'm trying to get back in here, but life is just too crazy. But thank you everyone for your ongoing support anyway. Okay, that's it. And I'll catch you later.